In this video, I'm going to teach you how to calculate beta in less than 10 minutes. It's a lot easier than it sounds and doesn't require any advanced math skills or knowledge. So if you've always wanted to know but never had someone explain it, then keep watching because I'll show you everything step by step with no fluff. So what's beta? Beta is a measure of volatility of an investment in relation to that of the market as a whole. By calculating beta, we can see if our investments are more or less volatile than the market and decide whether it's appropriate for us. In this video, I'll discuss how to calculate beta and why it can be important for your portfolio. Beta is a very important concept in finance that you should know about, but it's hard to find a good explanation of what beta actually means. Unfortunately, calculating beta isn't as easy as just plugging numbers into a formula and getting an answer. There are some things you need to consider before doing so, like what time period is being analyzed, which stocks are included in the analysis, and which index is used for comparison. Because of this complexity, most investors don't even bother trying to calculate their own betas because they think it would be too complicated or take too much effort. One of our viewers, Trent, wrote in and told us how he easily calculates beta. Here is what he had to say. I was unsure how to calculate beta. I looked online for answers, but it seemed like there were too many ways to go about it. So I set up a spreadsheet and tried out each one of the calculations that people suggested, literally one by one. After comparing them, I had an easier time figuring out which ones were worth using in my trading account. Now, my alpha has increased noticeably from when I first met with my financial advisor. Do you want to know how to calculate beta and become an alpha in your portfolio like Trent did? Keep watching. Beta is a measurement of the riskiness of an investment. It measures the volatility or systematic risk associated with a particular stock in comparison to the market as a whole. The higher your beta, the more volatile your investments are and vice versa. A high beta stock can be considered speculative because it has both greater potential for growth and loss than low beta stocks. You can use beta to assess how much risk there is in a particular security compared with other securities. If you are looking for low risk investments, then stocks with lower betas would be a better choice than those with high betas. A company's beta may change over time if its business mixes changes significantly or it undergoes some major event. Now watch this video to the end and you'll be a beta financial wizard. Please note, this video is not intended as financial or legal information and does not provide any financial or legal advice. If you need legal advice, contact a licensed attorney. If you need financial advice, please contact a licensed financial advisor. In this first segment, I'm going to show you how to calculate beta using a simple equation. But keep watching to the end as I'll be showing you how to interpret beta to your advantage. Let's get started. The first thing you should do is find a risk-free rate. Finding a risk-free rate is not a difficult task. Simply find out what types of investments an investor can make without risking any money, such as US Treasury bills for investments in US dollars or German government bonds for investment that trades in euros. These figures are normally expressed by percentage rates to show the low level of risk involved with them from potential risks like bankruptcy or inflation that may affect other forms of investing. The next thing is you should determine the respective rates of return for the stock and for the market or appropriate index. When investing in stocks, people often want to know how much the stock's return is over a certain period of time. This can be figured by looking at percentage rates or relative values. For example, an annual rate will tell you what percentage your money would make if invested every year, whereas a monthly rate tells you what percentage over the same amount. Both of these numbers are expressed as percentages. One could also have negative figures, which mean loss instead of gain on the investment when taken into consideration with other factors such as volatility and risk level. After determining the rate of return, you should now subtract the risk rate from the stock's rate of return. Quick example, if the risk-free rate is 4% and the stock rate of return is 9%, the difference would be 5%. Next, you should subtract the risk-free rate from the market or index rate of return. For example, if the market rate of return is 7% and the risk-free rate is 4%, the difference is 3%. The next step is to divide the first difference, 5%, by the second difference, 3%. The fraction is the beta figure, which will be expressed as a decimal value. The beta of the market itself, or the appropriate index, is by definition 1.0, as it's being compared to itself. Any number divided by that same number equals 1. A beta less than 1 means this stock is less volatile, which will remain stable in comparison with its peers. A value greater than 1 indicates high volatility, so you should keep an eye on things if you're invested there. When you're deciding on a beta, it is important to to be aware of the market in which your stock trades. For example, if an industrial company has been outperforming its average industry for some time, but it is now starting to decline, then comparing its performance against other stocks that are representative of the markets they trade, for example, the Dow Jones Industrial Average or the MSCI EAFE, would allow us to figure out what may have caused this change in trend and how we can react accordingly. I am now confident that you can calculate beta using that simple equation, but that's not it. There are other methods you should also look into, which I will discuss shortly in this video. In this next segment, I'm going to show you how to use beta to determine the stock's rate of return. This is very important. Beta can be used to determine the stock's rate of return. It will be very easy for you if you keenly follow the steps I'm about to share with you. The first step is you should find a risk-free rate. That is the same value as discussed previously. We will use 4% as an example. The next step is to determine the rate of return for the market or its representative index. We will use the same 9% as the example here. The next thing is you should multiply the beta value by the difference between the market rate of return and the risk-free rate. Assuming the beta value is 1.5%, then 9% minus 4% or 5% multiplied by the beta value. This should give 7.5%. You should now add the result of the risk-free rate. This should sum up to 11.5%. The higher the beta value for a stock, the more likely it is to have an increased rate of return. However, this increase in rate comes from the added risk, making it necessary to take into account other factors and fundamentals before deciding if that should be part of your portfolio. Now, I quickly want to show you how to use Excel graphs to determine beta. This is a very easy way too to determine beta. Keep watching as I'm about to share with you how to interpret beta to your advantage. The first step in using Excel graphs is to make three price columns in Excel. One column will contain all of your dates, and the second column will list indexes, the overall market, while the third will have prices on individual stocks. After making the three columns, enter your data points into the spreadsheet. Try starting with 1 month intervals and pick a date to start. At the beginning or end of each month, for example, then input what you find for that day's value on the index, like the S&P 500, as well as other stock prices. You can also go back in time by picking 15 or 30 recent dates from maybe about 12 months ago up until today, but make sure to note both values, including the index prices or level and stock price. You have to be careful when choosing a time frame for your beta calculations. If you choose too short of one, the accuracy won't improve much. However, on the opposite end of things, once you've chosen an appropriate amount of days or even weeks and months in which it's included historical data, then more accurate results will start coming out. After you have entered your data, create two return columns to the right of your price column. The column to the right of the index prices will be for the returns of the index. The column to the right of the stock's prices will be for the returns of the stock. After successfully adding these two return columns, begin calculating returns for the stock market index. To do this, type equals in the second cell of your index return column, type a dash in your index column, and then click on the first cell in your index column, then type a forward slash, and again, click on the index column again, hit return or enter. You will leave your first cell blank since return is a calculation over time. The equation might look like this: equals, open brackets, B4 minus B3, close brackets, divided by B3. After doing this, use the copy function to repeat the process for all the data points in your index price column. Use the copy function to repeat the process for all your data points in your index return column. Do this by clicking on the small square at the bottom right of one of those cells and dragging it down to every other cell with a different price below that row. What you are doing is asking Excel to replicate or make an identical formula as above for each point in time where there's more than just one showing up under index price. After doing so, you should repeat the same process for calculating returns, this time for the individual stock instead of the index. After you are through with this, you'll have two columns with percentages that list returns for both the stock index and the individual stock. The next step is to plot the data in a chart. There are many ways to plot data, but the scatter chart is one of my favorites because it can be used for any type of data set. Plot your data in a chart by highlighting all the return columns and hitting chart under home on Excel's toolbar. Select a scatter chart from the list, giving each axis an appropriate label, x-axis as index name and y-axis as stock name, respectively, or vice versa if you like reverse axis. After doing so, you should now add a trend line to your scatter chart. Make sure to choose a linear trend line time, not the others. The last thing is to find a coefficient for the X value in the equation of the trend line. Your trend line will be written as this. Your beta will be the coefficient of X value. In this last segment, I'm going to share with you making sense with beta. But quickly before that, let me show you how to interpret beta. To recap, when you invest in a particular stock, it is important to know how risky the investment is. That's why you need to compare its returns against not only that of an index, but also other stocks with similar characteristics. The beta measures this risk and should be interpreted as follows. If the beta number for your single stock or portfolio falls below 1, then it means less risk than when compared to the market. Anything over 1 indicates more risks than what would normally exist on average within individual companies involved in normal trading activity on exchanges today. The first step to making sense of beta is to know that risk is usually related to return. One way to think about risk is whether or not you want your investment to be volatile. A stock with low beta won't lose as much when stocks are falling, but also it will never gain as much when the market rises again. On the other hand, an investment with a higher beta can result in major losses if things take a turn for worse, and yet still give great returns on gains that happen during good periods of time. Another thing is to expect that a stock with a beta of 1 will move in lockstep with the market. Stock prices with a beta of 1 fluctuate to mirror the movement of their index counterparts. If you calculate a stock's beta and find it is 1, this means that every 1-point increase in your benchmark index, there will be an equivalent rise or fall in your stock's price too. For example, if the market goes up 2%, then so should any company with a beta of 1. And if the market goes down by 2%, then your stock would also go down by 2%, and vice versa. Lastly, put both high and low beta stocks in your portfolio for adequate diversification. Diversify your portfolio and be prepared for any dramatic downturns in the market. A mix of high beta stocks as well as low beta stocks will help you weather anything that comes. Of course, because the lower beta stock usually underperforms during a bull run, you won't experience the highest highs when times are good either. Take a look at the playlist on the screen to see other investment hacks. If you found this video helpful, please like, comment, and share it so it will reach others who also struggle with calculating beta.